Acharya Shri, you often mention nikachit karma in your talks. Can you explain the meaning?
Beautiful. The karma is very difficult to understand. This concept is complicated. Because people think you did something bad or you did something good, that is enough to get bad result or good result. That's what they think about it. But they don't know. They have to go in detail. There are categories of main karmas, are 8 types of main karmas. But how we collect them? Instead of I am explaining 8 type of karma, I am explaining you how we collect them, bad or good. So you have to understand there are particles floating in this whole universe, and they are countless particles. They are everywhere. As soon as your mind, your speech, or your body, they all together, they act something or react something, good or bad reaction. So the all particles, they come towards you and it makes like a big circle around you, and they get thicker and thicker and thicker. So mind, body and speech, because many things we do only by body. Action belongs to the body. Any action we do, that is the physical. And activities belongs to your mind. The mind is always in activities, involved in activities. So that is also kind of action, and that is even worse than physical action. Activities are even more dangerous. What about if we are involved in bad activities all the time? Can you imagine how much bad karma you will collect? But if someone is involved in good activities, helping, I want to have compassion, love, or I will want to forgive anything, anybody. So this is like a good activities. So the good activities brings the good karma. But there is a thoughts also, your good thoughts, bad thoughts, they also bring a lot of karma. So the karma is, you have 3 things. If 3 things are separate, like you're doing something action by body, it still doesn't collect the karma, which is called nikachit. Are you doing by your mind only? It still doesn't collect the nikachit karma. And if your thoughts are bad even, it still doesn't collect the nikachit karma. What collect the nikachit karma? If your intention is involved there too, by your physical action, suppose, your intention is bad too. Intention is called lesha, it is a special word for it. If your lesha is polluted, or your lesha is very good, so lesha, good lesha will bring lot of good karmas, or bad lesha will bring lot of bad karma. So now I want to categorize this, till otherwise you will not understand what nikachit means. There are 4 categories before you reach to the nikachit karmas. First category is called sparsh. Second is badh. Third is nidhat. Fourth is nikachit. What is sparsh karma? Sparsh karma is like your mind becomes polluted something and you begin to think good or bad. Like your mind becomes involved, your mind get involved in good activities, suppose. So, and it happened like few seconds. The good particles of the what is floating around you, it comes towards your soul. And it kind of touching that the other layers of the karma. because there are other layers already. That is called sparsh. Sparsh means it touches only. And after that, you get involved in the bad activities. Then, what is going to happen? You collect other bad particles. So after a while, after 1 hour, you realized, oh, you did something bad. My mind was polluted. It's not a good idea. So you straighten out yourself again. And you got involved in good activities a lot. And suppose you got involved in good activities, maybe 5 minutes. And whatever it touched to you, the bad particle of the karma, they get removed. Without giving result, it goes away. So you don't have to get result of that kind of first categories. First category is like, second category is Baddha. Baddha karma is like, you are involved in very bad activities, suppose. And you almost ready to act upon it. And when you are ready to act upon it, it not only touches the particles, not touches the other layers of the karma, it also stick there. When it stick, it's like a glue. It stick there. So that karma has to give you result. But it is very minor. It is like minimum result. Like somebody, and it can happen right away. Because you just get involved. You not really mean it, but your negativity is so strong. And after a while, your positivity took over it. But because it not only touched you, it got stick like a glue. Then you have to work a little hard on it to remove it. It still can be removed without giving the result. Third category is Nidhat. Nidhat is not only touch to you, or it doesn't stick on you, it sticks hard, like more than a glue, which is very difficult to remove it. But by efforts, you can still remove without even giving result. Three categories, it is in your hand. By efforts, you can remove those kind of karma with your efforts and good intention. But if you are not get involved in good intention and you don't put a lot of efforts is called sadhana. Sadhana is like spiritual practices. You do a lot of mantras, you do a lot of meditation, you help a lot of other people, or you help a lot of poor people, you lot of animals, birds, all the nature you help. So it is like you are involved in spiritual sadhanas, like fasting, suppose. So this is all many kind of spiritual practices. And that is we just say in one word, sadhana. By sadhana, you can remove all of these three. Fourth category is nikachit. Nikachit is not removable. You have to taste the result of it. Otherwise, it doesn't go away. It doesn't leave you. That is very strong. What is strong? Nikachit karma. Like somebody is a hunter. Hunter is hunting an animal. And it has a gun. And by the gun, he targets that animal, poor animal. And that, suppose the gun, the bullet, passed through a 1 tree, 2 trees, 3 trees, and it hit the animals. And the hunter jumps with joy that, look at my bullet, passed through the 3 trees and plus hit the animals too. I am perfect. I am this. He already killing someone. And on the top, he's celebrating, jumping, dancing with joy and happiness. That karma, because your intention, bad intention is involved there, that is called lesha, Krishna lesha. And Krishna lesha is the worst intention. when you jump with the joy, when you dance, when you celebrate, and you did bad something. So your karma will be nikachit. Nikachit means now it cannot be removed by efforts. But it can reduce, can be reduced only a little bit. If you will do a lot of sadhanas, lot of practices, spiritual practices, it might reduce the result. But if you never do the spiritual sadhana, it is not going to be reduced. It can become even worse. If somebody has this kind of bad nikachit karma, I am talking. So, and the person is not involved in the spiritual sadhana, spiritual practices, it is going to give even more result, worse result. But if somebody, after collecting this bad nikachit karma, and they get involved somehow with the spiritual practices, sadhana, then they reduce the result, the bad result. Like if somebody is supposed to get hanged, suppose that was the result. So that person, by efforts, it can reduce that it might be in the jail for 2 years. That much can be reduced. But it will still give to you. All these first 3 karmas, they can be removed by sadhana without giving any results. Without. But the 4th karma, it has to give you result. No matter it is a good karma, nikachit, or bad karma. The good karma, like you collected the good karma that you're supposed to be a king. Then, but somehow you got involved in a monkhood before even you get to become a king, then nikachit karma, how it will give that result? Because it is not removable. And you are a monk. But as a monk, you will be respected more than a king. That's the way it will give the result, different way. But it has to give the result. So it is better not to collect the nikachit karma. Nikachit karma is like you jump with the joy, with happiness. You dance, you celebrate. And if it is bad, it becomes worst karma. And if you jump with joy, with happiness, and you did something good, it is a good nikachit karma. It will give result too. Choice is yours, what you want to do. Let me give one more little thing, then you will understand. First category of karma is sparsh, it touches you. It is like a dry wall and you throw the sand, dry sand to the wall. It touches the wall and it fell down to the ground. Because the wall is dry, sand is dry. That is called first category. It just you have bad thoughts or bad mind, something. And then you switch yourself good by good thoughts or good mind. So it touches you and it falls down without giving result. Second is baddha. Baddha is like if the sand was little wet and you throw to the wall, the few sands will fall down and other will stick with the wall. And now wall will get dirty. You have to put little efforts to remove it. But third category is like a really like a clay. The clay, which is wet clay, and you throw to the wall, and the clay will stick to the wall, and by the time it dries, it is like really sticking to the wall. Then you have to put little efforts to remove it. But you still can, it is still can removable. But fourth is like a rock. And that rock is a big rock, and you want to dissolve this rock, you need a lot of efforts to put it. You can still do it, but it's not, because the pieces of rock, it might take you a big time. So it needs to put lot of efforts, but it might reduce the result only a little bit. That is nikachit karma. Nikachit karma is like a big, huge rock. And it is like it is very difficult to remove that rock. It needs a lot of effort. You can reduce it. You can make maybe the pieces of it, but it is very difficult to disappear everything. To disappear everything, you need lot of efforts, lot of sadhanas, and it only will reduce your Nikachit Karma's result. That is the fourth category. And Nikachit Karma, I tell you, never collect the Nikachit Karma. Three karmas category is good, but not fourth. Jai Siddhatma.
Can you reach enlightenment if you have Nikachit Karma or the first three categories of karma?
Yes, this is also a beautiful question because that people ask more often enlightenment. Till Nikachit Karmas are there, that is the big blockage in the enlightenment. Because Nikachit Karma has to give result first. If you collected bad or if you collected good, both ways. You have to first, they have to first give you the result. Without result, they cannot be broken. So you have to work hard on it. Till you get the result, you are not able to get enlightenment. So it is the worst thing to have it. Cannot get enlightenment. There is no way. But yes, three types, sparsh, badh and nidhat, I mentioned, they are not obstacle on the way to enlightenment because those are removable by sadhana. So that's what I tell people. Hey, get involved in sadhana, put a lot of efforts, at least three type of karmas can be removed. Fourth category, you have to wait. And that's why your enlightenment can be installed, can be delayed. So it is difficult. So whenever you understand this concept, it is better not to collect Nikachit Karma at all. Pay attention to your intention. Your intention has to be neutral. Neutral means you're not expecting the result. Even you are doing a lot of good things, don't expect that I want to go to heaven. I want to be a king. I want to be this. I want to be that. Then those Nikachit Karma will give you result. But if your intention is not involved and you are involved in the good activities, you're doing by physical good actions, helping others, so no expectation, no desire to get anything back, so it means your karma begin to burn. When your karma begin to burn, that is the way to reach towards enlightenment. Jai Siddhartha.